Each time you speak, more than 100 muscles work together to form the sounds that leave your mouth. These muscles also help to provide the breath behind your voice and make the facial expressions that accompany your words. Under the surface of your skin and deep within your body are muscles, more than 600 of them, that make up your muscular system. Rather than having just one type of muscle, your muscular system is actually made up of three specific and unique types of muscle: the skeletal muscles, which are responsible for moving your body, the cardiac muscles, which are found only inside of your heart, and the smooth muscles, which are found in blood vessels and some of your internal organs. When you think of your muscles, you are probably thinking of your skeletal muscles. You have more skeletal muscles in your body than any other type of muscle. They make up about 30 to 40% of your total body weight. Skeletal muscles are typically attached to the joints of your bones by strong connective tissues called tendons. Another tissue, called fascia, attaches muscles to other muscles. These three tissues, muscles, tendons, and fascia, work together to make your body move in a variety of ways. When you raise your arms out to the side, that is called abduction, or moving a body part away from the body. When you lower your arms back down to the sides, that's called adduction, or moving a body part toward the body. When you squat down, that's called flexion, which is bending a joint. And when you stand back up, that's called extension, or straightening a joint. Finally, moving your arm in a large circle is called rotation. All of these movements are made possible by the skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles are a voluntary muscle. This means you have to think about making them move. Your brain sends out electrical signals that tell the muscles what to do. Most skeletal muscles work in pairs. In your upper arm, you have two muscles, called biceps and triceps. When the bicep contracts or shortens, the tricep will extend or relax. When the bicep extends, the tricep contracts. This allows your lower arm to bend and move. While these paired muscles allow larger movements, such as throwing a baseball or doing a push-up, other skeletal muscles and muscle pairs stabilize and support our bodies. Unlike the voluntary skeletal muscles, smooth muscles and cardiac muscles are involuntary muscles. You don't have to consciously think about moving them. Smooth muscles receive signals from your brain that allow them to work automatically. Smooth muscles found in your blood vessels keep blood flowing throughout your body, delivering life-giving oxygen and nutrients without you having to think about it. More smooth muscle is found along your digestive system. This keeps food moving through your intestines and the rest of your digestive tract. These smooth muscles cause that familiar grumble in your stomach when you're hungry. The last type of muscle, cardiac muscle, is found only in the walls of your heart. It has one simple but very important job: to keep your heart beating. That's a big responsibility when you consider that your heart will beat about 2.5 billion times over the course of your lifetime. Imagine how different your life would be if you had to physically make your heart beat in the same way you have to make your feet move when you walk. Thankfully, the heart has unique, specialized pacemaker cells that work to automatically regulate your heartbeat. Cardiac muscles have a unique design that prevents them from growing tired, as they help the heart pump day after day after day. Although each type of muscle, skeletal, smooth, and cardiac, has its own specialized function, all three types of muscles are made up of special cells called muscle fibers. These fibers are groups of tiny threads bound together and encased within a strong cover. In skeletal muscles, the tissues are arranged in rounded bundles, like cords, allowing for the strong pulling necessary to move your body. In smooth muscles, however, the tissues are arranged in sheets. Cardiac muscles are specially woven to form the parts of the heart, contracting and relaxing in perfect rhythm. Muscles are essential for movement, for digestion, for keeping your heart beating strong, and for so many other bodily functions. And what you eat greatly impacts the health of your muscles. Proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins, and minerals all help your muscles to stay strong and replenish any lost tissues. Drinking enough water each day also provides the electrolytes that are essential for muscle strength and control. But the most important thing of all is to exercise. Our muscles don't stay the same throughout our lives, and they can change drastically depending on how they're used. That's why people who lift weights a lot have very large muscles, while other people don't. Lifting weights increases the work that the muscles have to do, which causes them to become larger. On the other hand, if muscles aren't used for a long period of time, they can waste away. Exercise keeps muscles strong and flexible, while lack of exercise can actually break the muscles down. So, what's the best type of exercise? It's the one you enjoy most, whether that's dancing, hiking, running, or climbing. All types of exercise help support your amazing muscular system.